In this video, we are going to discuss about some of the problems in epicyclic gear drawings. And for this video, I have taken some of the sample problems from the book Theory of Machines by S.S. Ratan. The epicyclic gear drive is also called as planetary gear drive. It is also called as planetary gear drive. In what way it is different from normal gear drive? Because there occurs relative motion of axis, which is not in the case of your simple compound or riveted gear drives. So in those gear drives, the axis will remain fixed when the gears or gear train meshes with each other, and the axis will not move. Whereas in case of epicyclic gear train, the axis of one or more gear just moves over the axis of another gear. In that way, it is called as epicyclic, or it is called as planetary gear trains. Okay. Now, the problems on epicyclic gear trains can be solved by algebraic method. It is like a normal method, algebraic method, or by a tabular method. So, in this video, we are going to discuss about solving epicyclic gear train problem using tabulation method. So let us go to the question straight away. So here you have an epicyclic gear train, and you got two gears A and B with 30 and 40 numbers of teeth. And speed of gear A is 80 rpm. It is rotating counterclockwise. The question is, we need to find the speed of gear B, and first condition is if gear A is fixed, and second condition is, instead of fixing gear A, if it is rotating at 240 rpm clockwise, and what will be the speed of the gear B? So here we have gear A is the first element in this gear train, and gear B is the second element in this problem. In addition to this, there is an arm. So let us denote the arm by a smaller case letter A. So in total, we have three elements. Keep in mind, the number of elements in epicyclic gear train is very important to solve the problems. Now the question, the picture for the question is not given, and we need to draw the picture for the given problem from the number of teeth. From the number of teeth which is given in the question, and gear B is larger and gear A is smaller, and you have an axis, you have an arm which connects these two gears. Now this is called as arm. So we have totally three elements. Now to solve the problem, we need to draw a table of motion as given in the video. Okay, so let arm be small a, gear A as caps A, gear B as caps B. Now for the table of motion, we have three rows only. Irrespective of n number of elements, we will have three rows only. And the second column, and this remains same for all the things. And number of columns here depends on number of elements. Now, as we said in the previous slide, there are three elements, that is gear A, gear B, and arm A. Therefore, we have taken, this is the first column, this is the speed of revolution for the second column, second element A, this is the speed of revolution for the third element B. So first column, second column, third column, these are the additional columns based on the number of elements, Now how to solve? Now the first step goes like this. Here is the first step. Assume arm is fixed, which means the speed of arm we need to assume, that is speed of arm is n suffix small a, should be taken as 0, and gear A should be taken as plus 1 revolution counterclockwise direction. Keep in mind, I will seek your attention here. in general sign convention, clockwise is taken as positive, counterclockwise is taken as negative. For solving problems by this method, I have taken, of course, different book prescribes different method, whether you can take plus as CW or plus as CCW, and but for my case, I have taken plus one revolution as counterclockwise direction. Okay, so arm is zero and gear A goes for plus one revolution CCW, which means the speed of gear A, the speed of the gear A, n suffix caps A is equal to plus one. We need to fix it here. Now this will come here and this will come to this cell. I'll explain in the next slide. Okay, now here is the case. Arm is fixed, A goes for plus one revolution counterclockwise. Therefore, as we said in the previous slide, speed of arm is zero. It is here, and speed of gear A is plus one. Now, how to get speed of gear B? How to get speed of gear B? Now we have to use the speed of the gear equation. Speed of the gear equation. We know that speed of the gear in terms of number of teeth is given by this relation. That is NB by NA is equal to TA by TB. NB by NA is equal to TA by TB. This is the equation. Now, as per our assumption, NA is 1. So, if you cross multiply, if when this goes up, it will be 1. Therefore, NB equal to TA by TB. And now, number of teeth on A is given in the question as 30. Number of teeth on B is given as 40. Let's come here. So TA is 30 and TB is 40. And don't forget to introduce minus sign here. The minus sign says that these two gears rotate in opposite direction. We know that when a pair of gear meshes, the gears will rotate in opposite direction. We assume this as plus, that is counterclockwise, which means this will be clockwise negative. Therefore, don't forget to introduce minus sign here. This is the first step. Now, second step, you have to multiply plus x in all the cells of the columns. Okay, that is plus x here. That is, if you multiply 0 into x, which is 0 given here, if you multiply plus 1 into x, this will give plus x. If you multiply minus 30 by 40 into x, so that will give minus 3 by 4x. This is the second step. Now, third step in solving problems in epicyclic gearing is again a simple step. That is, you have to add plus y in all the cells of the column. That is, you have to add plus y here, because at the end of the second step, you left with for arm A it is 0 and for gear A it is plus x, and for gear B it is this way. Okay, therefore 0 x plus x minus 3 by 4 x is there. You have to add 0 plus y, this results in plus y. 0 x plus y, the answer is here, and you have to add plus y to this, so the answer is here, y minus 3 by 4 x. That's all we have done with the table of motion. Now keep in mind, at the end of the table of motion, so we have speed of arm small a is plus y, speed of gear A as this thing, that is plus y plus x, speed of gear B as y minus 3 by 4x. These are the speed of elements of arm small a, gear A and gear B. Next, we need to solve the problem. We need to get the answer. Now, the question is, The question is, we need to find the speed of, we need to find the speed of the gear B. First condition is gear A is fixed. Gear A is fixed means, gear A is fixed means NA equal to 0. NA equal to 0. We need to fix NA equal to 0. Also, it is given in the question, arm is rotating 80 rpm. Arm is rotating 80 rpm. Now from the table of motion, you can see the speed of arm is plus y. Speed of arm is plus y. Therefore, plus y equal to 80. Plus y equal to 80. Also in the question, it is given that, keep in mind, also in the question, it is given that gear A is fixed. That is, speed of gear A is 0. From the table of motion, speed of gear A is here. That is, plus y plus x equal to 0. Therefore, if you substitute y here, that is plus y plus x equal to 0, you will get xs minus 80. You will get xs minus 80. Therefore, how to find the speed of gear B? Now from the table of motion, speed of gear B is here. This is the speed of the gear B. Y minus 3 by 4x. We know the value of y, which is given in the question. Just now we got the value of x. If we substitute here the values of y and x, we will get the answer as plus 140 rpm. Now this plus stands for the gear B is rotating at counterclockwise direction. Hope you are following this. So the trick in the table of motion is, if you are able to crack the first step, this step is very important. Then second step is, you have to multiply with plus x, and third step is you have to add plus y. That's all. Now these are the speed of evolution for A, gear A, gear B, and there will be some conditions and the constraints given in the question. Based on the constraint and conditions, we got the speed of gear B as 140 rpm counterclockwise direction. So this is the first part of the question, and first part of the question is gear A is fixed. Now the second part of the question is, again we need to find, the speed of gear B, but instead of fixing the gear A, it is mentioned as the speed of gear A rotates 240 rpm clockwise, which means speed of gear A is, minus 240. Now from the table of motion, you can see the speed of gear A is plus y plus x. So substitute plus y plus x here. As minus 240. Already we know plus y as 80, which is the part of the question. So we got x as minus 320. Now to find the speed of gear B, again go back to the table of motion. This is the speed of gear B. So you have this equation. Substitute y and x, and you'll get answer as plus 320 rpm, which means the speed of gear B is 320 rpm counterclockwise direction. So in that way, we need to solve the problems. Okay. So let me recap this. And so there are two gears A and B. Number of teeth is 30 and 40. In addition to this, there is an arm which rotates at 80 rpm counterclockwise direction, which is the part of the question. Keep in mind, this is the part of the question. Okay. Right. So totally we have three elements: gear A, gear B, and arm small a. Three elements. So since we have three elements, we need to open three columns, additional columns, in addition to serial number and action. And first row is fixing the arm, assuming gear AS plus 1 revolution counterclockwise direction. And we got all the values. Second step is multiply all the elements by plus x. You will get the second row. Third, you have to add plus y and apply the conditions. You will be able to solve the problem.